So now we're going to talk about click-through rate. And to actually see click-through rate on your YouTube analytics, you have to go to the new YouTube Studio Beta. And you can do this by going to your analytics, and then you'll see this button right up here that says YouTube Studio Beta. You can just click that. And then you can actually go on certain videos. And as you can see, it also shows audience retention right here. Within the new YouTube Studio Beta, shows the real-time activity, how many views that video is getting. And as you can see in the new YouTube Studio Beta, I actually really like this layout right here. This video has a really good audience retention, 71%. As I was saying, this is a different video. As you can see, I've improved from that last video that got 10 million views, and I've been able to keep people's attention much better. As you can see, they watch all the way through. There's no real drops in the audience retention, and people watch all the way through generally pretty good. And as you can see, these are the real-time views. Last 48 hours, 17,000 views. And I really like the new YouTube Studio Beta too, because you can actually see like the first couple hours, like how much watch time and how many views the video got within the first couple hours and how many it's been getting since then. And you can also see revenue too, but revenue just shows per day. So as I was saying, to actually see the click-through rate, we want to click this Reach Viewers button right here. And then we can scroll down, and as you can see right here, I really like this upside down pyramid that they have right here, because it shows the amount of impressions on your video. So it shows how many people have seen like the thumbnail and the title for your video when they're going through YouTube. And then it shows the click-through rate of how many people actually clicked that video. As you can see, this video has a 10% click-through rate. Now, YouTube actually put out a statement saying that half of all videos on YouTube are between 2 and 10% click-through rates, 10 being on the high end and 2% being on the low end. So as you can see, this video has a very good click-through rate being at 10%. And then through this little bar right here, you can see how much YouTube is recommending your content. And now click-through rate, you don't want to look at any of these analytics by themselves necessarily. You want to look at them together and make an understanding based off of looking at all these different analytics together. Because click-through rate is entirely dependent on your thumbnail and your title. So that's going to be what drives people to actually click the video and watch. But the amount of time that they actually watch the video, which is watch time, which is the most important, that's why YouTube puts it at the bottom of this pyramid, because this pyramid represents a funnel. So it captures the audience's retention. First off, with the thumbnail and the title, they click it, 10% of people click it, which results in 27,000 people watching the video. And then based off of your average view duration and the audience retention, as we were talking about in the last lesson, most people watch about 72% of that video, which results in that 90,000 minutes of watch time. So you want to look at all these analytics together, and I really like this new data point that YouTube allows in the new YouTube Studio Beta, showing the impressions and how they led to watch time. So really look at all of these analytics together and find out which the points you're strong on, because you might be strong on click-through rate, but YouTube still isn't going to recommend your video if you don't have like a really good average view duration and you're not getting a lot of watch time, which is again why those longer videos do so good. And I found that like compilation videos and whatnot do very good too, if you're switching like the clip like every 30 seconds, because that keeps people's attention. That, let's say they watch for 30 seconds, and if you just kept showing the same clip all the way through, they might get bored. So if you just switch the clip at 30 seconds, or you're making one of those technology compilation videos that I was talking about, you switch the clip like every minute in a 10-minute video, that's going to keep people's attention all the way through. And then you couple that with a really good thumbnail, which is going to increase your click-through rate, have a really good title, then you're going to start getting recommended by YouTube throughout like suggested videos and everything in browse features and YouTube search, and you're going to really start blowing up on YouTube. So that is my best recommendations of how to look at your analytics and start getting views by optimizing what you're strong on and getting rid of what you're weak on. So you want to upload as many videos as possible, guys. Don't be scared to upload videos and be scared like, oh, I don't know if it's going to get as much watch time as I'd like. You want to upload as many videos as possible, because this is going to provide as many data points as possible, because then you can see like which videos did good, which videos did bad. I want to cut out videos like this. I want to double down on videos like this. And you might want to keep making the same videos, but you might want to change certain things about the videos, like a different thumbnail, say, or let's say like a different title, different tags. You want to see what's going on and how you can get the most views. So these are my best recommendations on how to look at your analytics and get the most views.